I just burped up my nachos. They're amazing. I should have got one of those giant, like, bootleg margaritas.
Oh my goodness.
Make me feel so
and
good.
And then you start going to New Orleans and looking for those beads.
Yeah, that's right.
Tornado. What are those things called? Tornadoes?
Hurricanes.
This would be so much more fun. Just record this.
Hi, I'm Burke Collins.
And I'm Julie Lerman.
And this is five ways that you can interact with data from your favorite editor, VS Code.
Yeah.
Thing number one is the Azure Cosmos DB extension for VS Code. Now, this is an extension that I know, I love, I use it all the time. What exactly does it do?
The extension lets you connect to an Azure Cosmos database in Azure and see all of your databases, all of your collections, your documents. You can edit documents, you can create documents. So you can really see it. Now there's the Document Explorer in the Azure portal, which is also wonderful and awesome. But if you're working in Visual Studio Code and you want to see something about your data, you can just open it up and look at it right there.
Yep, that's true. And
awesome.
Fun fact about that extension, because Cosmos DB supports the MongoDB API, you can use that extension to connect to any MongoDB database, not just Cosmos DB. So even if you're using MongoDB, check out the Azure Cosmos DB extension because you can use that to query and manage your data all without ever leaving VS Code. Because why would you ever want to leave?
Who wants to leave Visual Studio?
I don't ever want to leave. I want to die there. Thing number two is the SQLite extension for VS Code. Now this is interesting. I had no idea that there even was a SQLite extension for VS Code.
Neither did I. It's brand new. Well, it's been around maybe for a little while, but I'd been hoping somebody would create one. I'd used a Postgres one, but anytime I was using SQLite on Mac OS, I have to use a bigger tool or a specialized tool just to look at the data because I want to see, you know, what I created. So it's just nice to know somebody from the community created this extension. It's out there. It's just SQLite, VS Code-SQLite, I think it's its name.
Yeah, so check that out. I know a lot of people are using SQLite. I don't know a lot about SQLite, but it is, I guess it's a sort of a cross-platform, very lightweight data store that
open
you can
source.
Use with your application.
Yep.
So it's kind of like Microsoft Access.
No, not really.
See, it's not at all like Microsoft Access.
Not at all.
That's what I just said.
Good,
nice,
good winging
good
it.
Good recovery perk.
Yeah.
I could do this all day. Thing number three is something called Azure Data Studio. Now, Julie, I thought we were telling the nice people about extensions for VS Code. And now we're talking about, what is this?
I know, I'm
so
sorry.
How does this relate, what is it and how does it relate to VS Code?
So originally, the SQL Server team created an extension for Visual Studio Code called the MS SQL extension. And I've been using that and really loved it. And then what they did was they created, they pulled it out and created their own spawn of Visual Studio Code that is just, it takes Visual Studio Code and just does the data access in there. So it interacts with all variations of SQL Server databases. It was originally called SQL Operations Studio, but they changed the name to Azure Data Studio. So I'm hoping that that eventually it will be more than just interacting with SQL Server.
So more databases.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I've downloaded this recently. You should check it out, it's fantastic. Especially if you're not on Windows, because SQL Management Studio on Windows is wonderful. But if you're on a different operating system, you're just kind of left high and dry. This one looks like VS Code. So when you open it, you'll swear, you'll be like, this looks familiar.
Yeah. And it has the source control, so you know you can
maintain
files.
Right, it's got all the visual aspects. You can look at the tree. You can execute queries. You get the IntelliSense inline
snippets.
Right, all of the code
and also access to a CLI. Right, access to a terminal. So you could be doing some CLI stuff. Maybe you're using the MS SQL command, you know, command line, or just using some command line tools. So it's a very similar experience to using Visual Studio Code. And if you know how to use Visual Studio Code, you know how to use this. You know how to work with the settings.
Yeah, that's Azure Data Studio. you should check that out. And you've got an article on MSDN.
It
about
just came
this.
Out a well, couple days
be
ago.
In the, notes for the show, you can check that link out.
Yep.
Thing number four. So we talked about Azure Data Studio. One of the things that it does that's quite interesting is something called profiling. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, the profiling actually is an extension. So the same way Visual Studio Code has the whole ecosystem with extensions.
Ah, okay.
So does
Azure Data Studio.
Studio
has it as well.
So the SQL Server team wrote this extension that does database profiling. So like SQL Profiler, right? I've used SQL Profiler all the time on my Windows machine. But when I'm on my Mac and working with my databases, it's not something I can, you know, there's no tool.
Right, there's no equivalent.
So they've actually now created an extension. It's in preview right now, but they've created an extension that you can profile the work that you're doing or what's happening in the database. There's all different kinds of ways to do it.
So that's a cool extension. I actually don't use profiling. What I do is I execute the query, and then when it never returns, I just call the DBA and ask them to fix it. Also a perfect solution
actually,
to your problems.
For your scenario, that's probably the best
path. The best thing to do. Burke, don't mess with the SQL. Let somebody else do it.
Yeah.
Thing number five is the flat file importer extension for Azure Data Studio. Now, this one is interesting to me because anybody who has ever tried to import a flat file into a database knows that that is a nightmare. It's terrible.
Yes, and you didn't even use any foul language to
describe
that.
I feel like I did very well.
Yes, it is always a lot more work than you ever want it to be or expect it to be because you have to tell how many columns there are, what the format is, what the schema is, all this stuff. So what's amazing about this, but it's like it uses artificial intelligence, and it's something that's kind of a bigger thing that's being developed in SQL Server, but they're taking advantage of it in this extension.
So that's how hard importing a flat file is.
You need
we
an
have
AI.
To have an AI. These are the problems that we're solving with AI importing flat files.
But that's amazing, right?
It is amazing. Yeah. So it's a cool extension, and you could be able to import a flat file without using expletives.
Your brain.
Yeah, or your brain, you're right.
Use
the computer's brain.
I don't do AI, I'm not AI.
Me neither.
It really, it's really cool what it does, and it can do, CSV files, JSON files. Now that's flat files though, not like JSON hierarchical files or anything like that, maybe
someday.
But yeah. So, I mean, it's just in preview. I was working with early bits with it, an early version. I actually got a chance to get on the on Skype with the team and show them things that I was doing because I was banging on it, and it wasn't doing things the way I thought it would be, and they took notes and made changes, so that was kind of cool.
Awesome. Yeah. So that is the flat file importer extension for Azure Data Studio, complete with artificial intelligence to actually get your flat file imported.
Yeah.
I'm Burke Collins.
And I'm still Julie Lerman.
Yep, and now you know five different ways that you can work with data inside of Visual Studio Code and
it's Spawn,
Azure
Data
Studio.
All right.
Perfect. My people, I love you both so much. Bring it in.
You're the best, Burke.
Thank you, Caitlin.
Thank you,
Kim. Thank you, Julie.